بعد قال إمام الرضا عليه السلام اللهم صل على كلمة لا إله إلا الله حصني فمن دخل من دخل على حصني أمن من عذابي ولكن بشرطها وشروطها وأنا من شروطها صلوات السلام عليكم جميعا ورحمة الله وبركاته أسعد الله أيامكم جميعا and congratulate all the brothers and sisters upon the auspicious occasion of the wilada of Imam Ali al-Riḍā alayhi salam. Inshallah, it will take me a minute just to sort of take in this bigger crowd that I've not been used to in Toronto, and you saw me climbing onto this minbar, which was a challenge in itself. Brother Abbas Ali is laughing. So inshallah, you will bear with me, and inshallah, you will benefit together from this jashn today that is held with the munasibah of the eighth Imam, who is well known with the title Al-Riḍā. Although the Imam alayhi salam's name is Ali. Now, from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, or the 14 Masumeen alayhi salam, except for Sayyidah Zahra salamullah alayha, being the one and only unique female amongst them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose amongst them four Muhammads, four Ali, two Hassan, and one Hussein. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made sure that where he had four Muhammads, he kept four Ali. To make sure that there will be no distance in between Muhammad and Ali. Yeah. So the Imam alayhi salam's name is what? Ali. He was given the titles such as Wafi, Sabir, the loyal one, the patient one. Dhamini Ahu, although this laqab is not necessarily from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. But he was the guarantor of the day that said, O Mawla, give me some time. I need to feed my child and I guarantee you I will be back, even though I know you're going to hunt me. Then the Imam alayhi salam was the guarantor. But this laqab or this title was given from the people living at that time or even from the modern era. But there were certain alqab that were giving, that was given to this holy Imam, such as Al-Riḍā, that's very special. Why? Because Imam al-Jawad alayhi salam states, he says, Imam al-Riḍā, my father, Riḍā, was called Riḍā because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure lies within the personality of Imam Riḍā. And the pleasure of Imam Riḍā alayhi salam has then gone to the Imams after him and was even there before him. Meaning that Allah is pleased with Imam Riḍā alayhi salam, and the Imams before him and after him are all pleased with Imam Riḍā alayhi salam. Now it's a different story that certain Muslims may call other personalities or other people radiyallah, hoping and praying that maybe Allah will be Radhi and pleased with these people. But one thing is for me and you to pray for something or someone that's infallible, makes mistakes, that Allah will be pleased upon him. And it's another story when Allah says, I am pleased with you, O Riḍā. O Ali al-Riḍā, I, Allah, am pleased with you. Okay, so the name is what? Ali. You know what's interesting is that we all tend to try and find modern new names. Let's try a name that nobody has. Let's try a name that the neighbor's child doesn't have. You know, I like the name Muhammad, but what can I do? My nephew's name is Muhammad. I like the name Ali, but my younger brother's name is Ali. I like the name Hussein, but the neighbor's child's name is Hussein. Then what do? We try to find new names. We go towards Star Plus Drama. We go towards Hum TV. I don't know. For those of you that understand a little bit of Urdu, they'll relate to me. Right? So we go towards these names, or even certain names that rolls off the tongue easier. Mathalan, I came across a little girl when I was in Meshi, when I used to study in Najaf. One of the years we went to Meshi, and there was a father that called his cute little daughter by saying Siniya. For those of you that know Arabic, Siniya means what? Tray. I said, brother, how come you named your daughter Siniya? I thought maybe there's a, you know, there's another meaning to this word that I'm not aware of. He said, no, it's true. It doesn't mean tray, but it was just very easy to pronounce and it sounds beautiful. But it means tray, right? And then certain mathalan, and hopefully, now God help me, I hope there's no sister called Siniya, because then maybe Maulana Sahib will be getting a few emails. Inshallah, that won't be the case, right? But the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, their mentality was different. They loved the names of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam and of the Anbiya so much that they would repetitively have these names in their family. You see in the name Abdullah, certain, several of the Ahlul Bayt's children were called Abdullah. You see the name Muhammad, you see the name Hussein, you see the name Qasim, you see the name Ali. In fact, one day Marwan approaches Imam Sajjad alayhi salam in Medina. He says, Ma ismuka? What's your name? Imam Sajjad alayhi salam says, Ismi Ali. My name is Ali. Ma ismu akhika al-akbar? What's your elder brother's name? He said, Ali. He said, Ma ismu akhika al-asghar? What is your younger brother's name? He said, what? Ali. He says, Ali, 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 Ali. Couldn't your father think of another name? Go ask your father. Imam Sajjad alayhi salam approaches his father. Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam, he says, oh father, today Marwan asked me a question. He said, could your father not have thought of another name than Ali? All of his sons are Ali. Your dad couldn't think of another name? Imam alayhi salam gave a beautiful reply to that. He says, lo wulida li alf walad. If Allah was to grant me 1,000 sons, I would have named them all Ali. Yeah. I would have named them all Ali. We should love the names that were loved by the Ahlul Bayt. We should love. It does not matter how many Ali we have in this world. We can never have enough Ali's in this world. We can never have enough Husseins in this world. We can never have enough Muhammads in this world. Do not worry. Don't get too disturbed by the thought of the neighbor having the same name, or the brother or the nephew. No. It shouldn't be the case. The mi'yar and the standard should be the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The mi'yar should be the pleasure of Muhammad and Ali Muhammad. Sallu ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. So Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, inshallah, I do know brother Mahbub, he just told me, he said the watch is right in front of you, but I forgot what time, until what time I was allowed to speak. So inshallah, somebody will tell me again, I completely forgot. You know, in UK, we have a very famous majlis there every 20th of June. In that majlis, there is about maybe 10 to 20 speakers. And what they do is when they give you the time in bracket, in bracket, it says Khoja time. And I was never aware of what it meant before today. Now I know what it means. So inshallah, I'll try and be within my time. But inshallah, maybe Brother Abbas Ali can just quickly ask and let me know. So Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, this great Imam, Imam al-Thamin, Imam al-Dhamin, the Imam that's the eighth Imam, the Imam that's the guarantor of the day, the Imam alayhi salam who's loyal, the Imam alayhi salam that's patient, the Imam alayhi salam who is Riḍā, who is the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was born on the day of the 11th of Dhul Qadah. That's why we are gathered here today in the munasibah of the wilada of Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam. Now, Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, when he came to this world, and by the way, when these masumeen come, or even when their mothers are pregnant with them, you see them testifying, just like the mother of Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, who is Bibi Najma. Bibi Najma, in certain narrations, are also called Tahira. Why? That is because after giving the birth to Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, people would now call her Tahira because she had given birth to a child named Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, who was the paykar, who was filled with purity and piety. So Bibi Najma Khatun says, she says that when I sleep, I don't feel the burden of Imam Rida alayhi salam. When I walk whilst being pregnant, I don't feel the burden of Imam Rida alayhi salam. Maybe the reason of that is what? Is because their asl is from Nur. Their origin is from Nur. And Nur doesn't carry burden with them. So maybe that's why there was no burden that was felt by Bibi Najma salamullah alayha. And then what does Bibi Najma says? She says that when this child was born, the first thing I saw was what? That this child went into sujood, prostration, and starting to do what? The tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is no ordinary imam. Imam al-Rida alayhi salam has a very unique place amongst the Ahlul Bayt. Very unique. And even after his martyrdom, even after his istishhad, what do the narrations say? Yes, there are similar narrations about the other imams alayhi salam. For those of you that go to Karbala and Najaf and those that haven't been, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take you. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repetitively takes us all for the ziyarah of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. But there are certain narrations that are repetitively mentioned with the same nas. Mathalan, whoever visits the grave of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, ghafarallahu zunubahu. Whoever visits the grave of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove his sins. Likewise with the ziyarah of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. Likewise with the ziyarah of Imam Rida alayhi salam. But when it comes to, mathalan, the ziyarah of Imam Hussein, then individually every person from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam have certain specific ajr and rewards when it comes to their ziyarah. For example, Imam Hussein alayhi salam's ziyarah's reward is what? The narration mentions for each qadam, each step that you take towards the grave of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write down 70,000, or the riwayah, the other narration mentions 70 maqboola hajj and umrah for you. For those of us that have been in hajj, who can guarantee that we've gone to hajj and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted it? Can anybody guarantee that? No, we don't know. We hope and pray and we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy. But when it comes to Imam Hussein alayhi salam's grave, the ma'soom says that you don't have to worry. Allah has already accepted your hajj here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already accepted your umrah. But somebody asked Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, but what happens when it comes to the ziyarah of Amir al-Mu'mineen? Well, if the thawab is such with the ziyarah of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, then what about the ziyarah of Amir al-Mu'mineen? Then the Imam alayhi salam says, you know, whilst going to the qabr of Hussein alayhi salam, the ajr and the reward you get going with Amir al-Mu'mineen, when you return back to your own house and room of the hotel, then you will get the same thawab as you get going to Imam Hussein alayhi salam. So once again, with each of the imams, there are specific unique rewards with each of the imams of the Ahl Bayt alayhi salam individually. Let me tell you about this unique ajr that you get when it comes to the ziyarah of Imam Rida alayhi salam. When we go to Mashhad, whenever a friend of yours goes to Mashhad, when you call them and ask him, how do you feel? What answer do we often get? The person says, it feels like I'm in paradise. It feels like I'm in Jannah. And in fact, that's not only a feeling. The narration mentions مَقْبَرَتُهُ رَوْضَةٌ مِّن رِيَاذِ الْجَنَّةِ. The place where Rida alayhi salam is buried is a garden of paradise. That's why you have this feeling that when you go to Imam Rida alayhi salam, it's as if being in Jannah. You're already in Jannah at that moment. But what's that unique reward that we get from Imam Rida alayhi salam? Imam Rida alayhi salam makes a promise that I have not seen in other narrations. The Imam alayhi salam says, I promise you, O Mazair, I promise you, however many times you come to visit me, I shall come visit you in your grave. However many times you come visit Rida alayhi salam 10 times, and then Mawla Rida will come visit you 10 times. Go to the ziyarah of Rida alayhi salam 20 times, and the Imam alayhi salam will come visit you in your grave 20 times, and he will be with you in those moments that will be very heavy on us, such as the Sirat, such as the Niza', such as the Judgment Day itself. Now, who is Imam al-Rida alayhi salam? Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam is the son of Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Amongst his alqab, as I mentioned, he is the one that's al-Wafi. He is the one who is as-Sabir. Another laqab that's given by the Ma'sumin alayhi salam to Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam is what? He is the one that's called Alim wa Ali Muhammad. He is the scholar of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, and that's not my words. That's the word of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam that said to his own son, O Musa Kazim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you a son by the name of Ridha, and he will be the scholar amongst the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. But what does that necessarily mean? Does that mean that the ilm Imam Ridha alayhi salam carried, Imam Musa al-Kazim didn't carry that, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam didn't carry that? No. That means that from a specific aspect, you know, the way that Imam Ridha alayhi salam got to propagate certain ulum of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, that's why he got famous for that. And that's why Imam Sadiq alayhi salam is already making his son aware of that. The Imam alayhi salam is called Alim wa Ali Muhammad, but then again, he is most famous for his laqab of being al-Ridha. Let's speak about pleasure and a small little saying of Imam Ridha alayhi salam when it comes to the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, it should be amongst the right of the person who's already called Ridha, you know, the pleased one, or the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To speak about the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he mentions, man radiya. Man radiya min Allahi bil qalil min rizqi. Whoever is content with whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you min rizq, from his rizq, even if it's very little, then remember, then what? Radiyallahu minhu bil qalil min amal. Then remember, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in comparison to other people, have given you less rizq, in comparison to other people, mathalan, you drive around in a Camry, right? And you look around and you see people with the GMCs. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has maybe given you less. But Imam al-Ridha alayhi salam says, from one angle, it's a blessing in itself. How? Because the less that you have from the rizq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the less of responsibility you have when it comes to actions. Imam Ridha alayhi salam is not only consoling us, he's making us aware. Be happy with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. If you have less, your responsibilities are less. But if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you more, then automatically you have more responsibilities. Min al-amal, right? In actions, meaning what? Even spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or even being able to attend certain meetings or certain gatherings where a normal person, a layman person, or even a poor person can't attend because he's working 9 to 5, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's pleasure lies within the person that is now happy with that and content. And by the way, there are certain things that you can't ever have enough of. The person who has thousands would want, you know, 10,000. The person that would have 10,000 would like a lakh. The person who had lakhs, he would like what? Millions and billions. You can never get enough of money. And that's why Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam in Nahj al-Balagha says what? Allah. Amir al-Mu'mineen says, remember that true wealth actually lies within you being content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you. Otherwise, automatically you'll go into the world of anxiety, depression, just looking around, why does this person have more than me? Why does that person have more than me? But whether it's 100 or 1,000 or 1,000,000 or 1,000,000,000, if you are content with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, I promise you, you will sit happy at home. Even if that means that you are having bread and yogurt. Does not matter. Doesn't have to be the fancy mandeza, no? Correct? So, if you are happy with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you, then content with it, then in itself, you will feel you're rich. You will feel you're respected and honored. You will be happy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be happy with you. Now, there's a small little journey of Imam Ridha alayhi salam that I want to speak about today. And inshallah, I've been ordered to start out with English and then end my 10 minutes with Urdu. Usually where I go, it's the opposite. Start with English 10 minutes and carry out the rest in Urdu. Khair inshallah, you'll bear with me. So Imam al-Riḍā alayhi salam, whose era of Imamah does not start until he's 35 years old. That's when Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam leaves this world. He's martyred. Imam alayhi salam until then is working upon the same university, the same institution that was established by Imam Muhammad Baqir alayhi salam in his time. And then furthermore, this institution and university prospered and, you know, progressed to a level where Imam Sadiq alayhi salam was able to graduate so many students that our fiqh today is famous for the fiqh of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. Carry in your mind, believe this, that the ilm of Imam Sadiq was no less or more. They are all Muhammads. Awwaluna Muhammad, Awsatuna Muhammad, Akhiruna Muhammad. A beautiful example given by one of the ulama is just like the Holy Quran, right? It's one book, but when you divide them into all the surahs, they are 114, correct? 1 and 14. Now, if you look at the surahs individually, you have all these surahs from Fatiha till Suratul Nas, correct? All these surahs. So you have Surah Yunus and Hud and Jumu'ah, waghairihi. You have all these surahs. But if you put them together, they're all Quran, divide them into 114, they have each of their name. Just like that, the Ahlul Bayt are all Muhammad. Divide them and you'll see Ali, you'll see Hassan, you'll see Hussein, all the way up till Al-Qa'im Al-Mahdi. So in their knowledge, they're the same. It's one of the signs of the Imamah, right? Amongst the signs of the Imamah is what? Al-ilm, wa-sakhawa, wa-shuja'a. Their knowledge, their generosity, and their bravery. Amongst them is also them having what? Sayf al-Dhulfiqar. The same Dhulfiqar that was in the hand of Amirul Mu'mineen alayhi salam. That same sayf came to Imam Ridha alayhi salam. This same sword will come in the hands of Imam al-Hujja ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. So we see those amongst the signs. They all have this level of ilm. They all have this level of generosity. They all have this level. Likewise, Imam Ridha alayhi salam. Now he's propagating ilm. Where? In Medina. The same institution that was established by Imam Muhammad Baqir, but was taken to another level by Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. Imam Ridha alayhi salam then, after the martyrdom of Imam Musa al-Kadhim alayhi salam, at one point is summoned to Tus, Khurasan. By who? A person, a caliph named Ma'mun. Who's Ma'mun? He's the son of Harun. Harun had two sons. One of them was named Ma'mun, or the other one Amin. Maybe he had other sons, but I only mentioned these two because they were mentioned in the history books more. And one of them became the caliph in Baghdad and the other one became the caliph in Persia. What was the reason for that? Because in his own lifetime, his both sons were actually fighting with each other. After my father, I will be the Khalifa. Ma'mun said, I will be the Khalifa. Amin said, I will be the Khalifa. Harun turned around and said, I'm not even dead yet. You know, let me die and then you can fight. But no. So he thought to himself, you know, why don't I do this? That Amin's mother was an Arab, so hence he can stay the Khalifa in Baghdad. And Ma'mun's mother was Persian, hence he can be the Khalifa in Persia. So he made it clear to them, when I die, that's you will do. That's what you will do. They said, okay. So Ma'mun becomes the Khalifa of Baghdad and Ma'mun becomes the Khalifa of Khurasan and Tuz, and Amin becomes the Khalifa of Baghdad. Now, Ma'mun looks around, he sees the Shia of Ahlul Bayt, of Ali ibn Abi Talib amongst him. Around him are the Shias of Ali ibn Abi Talib. So in order to gain their support, he thought to himself, why don't I call the son of Ali ibn Abi Talib? I call Ridha alayhi salam with me, automatically the Shias around me will be my supporters. Imam Ridha alayhi salam refuted and rejected this offer. He said, you'll become my heir apparent? He said, no, I do not wish to. At one point, he forces the Imam. One thing is to give an invitation. Another thing is to summon someone. And then a third thing is to actually force him. The Imam alayhi salam is now forced, leaves Medina. When he leaves Medina, he takes some of his companions with him. This journey was very long. But I promise you, no matter how much the tyrants of the world try to belittle the Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam, they forgot that whoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give izzah, nobody can stop that. So this journey began. Every junction, every street, every city, Imam alayhi salam would still propagate the deen. And obviously now the theme had another, you know, color. Why? Because at certain points up until the era of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, it was very important to call people towards the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But you'll notice a slight change. After the time of Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, because they were only because the majority had already now accepted the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was no need to discuss that furthermore. So now you see that they were calling them towards the way of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Imam Ridha alayhi salam begins this journey. One factor that's very interesting when it comes to this journey is that Imam Ridha alayhi salam, when he reaches Qum, he is the first person to systematically arrange and organize the majalis of Imam Hussein alayhi salam when it comes to Ashra Ula. Very first person. Before this, yes, they would mourn Imam Hussein alayhi salam. The Shias would cry for Imam Hussein. The Shias would carry the love for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. But this organized manner, it wasn't found before Imam Ridha alayhi salam. Imam Ridha alayhi salam gets to Marv, an area. What does the Imam alayhi salam do? Imam alayhi salam, he wants to now pray. But as he sees there's no water, amongst the karamat of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam, or the karamat of Imam Ridha alayhi salam, and I'll mention why I'll speak of the reason for why I mentioned Marv. The Imam alayhi salam gets off, there's no water, gets off the horse and there's no water. By the karama of Imam Ridha alayhi salam, they find a spring from which they all do wudu and drink water. Once now, the Imam alayhi salam is now leaving Marv. As he is leaving Marv, what happens? Inshallah, chand nukat aur aapki zahmat tamam. Ab main Urdu ki taraf chala jaun, koi zyada tar samjhenge to sahi na, 5-10 minute hai mere paas. Wo thoda thoda wo hum Stockholm mein gaye, bradaran the hamare khoja bradar, to majlis mein wo majlis ke baad mujhe kehte hain Maulana bahut achhi majlis padi. Maine kaha kaash wo majlis mein kehte. Huh? Even a very good would do, inshallah. Ko thoda thoda bolenge, so I know that you're listening. Theek hai? So the Imam alayhi salam gets to Marv. Now at this point, in Marv, there are gathered more than 30,000 ulama and scholars and narrators. Yani 30,000 se zyada raviyan aur ulama wahan par maujood hain. Sab ko pata hai ki Imam alayhi salam ab kahan ja rahe hain? He's going towards Khurasan, Tus, right? So by the way, this whole area, this is why in the ziyarah, when you recite the ziyarah of Imam Ridha alayhi salam, what do you mention? You remember, you mentioned the Imam of Tus. That's not because Tus and Mashhad is a different area. Back then Tus was the whole bigger area, and now where the Imam alayhi salam is buried is called Mashhad. Correct? So now, Imam alayhi salam, as he is leaving, all these ulama is saying that you are going towards Tus, you're about to reach Tus. Can you at least give us one sentence that we can take with us? One lesson, small, mukhtasar aur mufeed. Chhota sa koi sabak mola de dijiyega, hum isko apne saath le jayenge. Inshallah tawajjuhat mere saath rakhiyega. Us waqt Imam alayhi salam ne us hadith ka zikr kiya jiska silsila jo hai, jiska silsila is sanad-e-zahabi hai. Sanad-e-zahabi meaning the golden chain of narration. Right? What does it mean when we say the golden chain of narration? That means that when the Imam alayhi salam started this saying, this riwayah, he said, I heard from my father Musa al-Kadhim, who heard from his father Ja'far al-Sadiq, who heard from his father Muhammad al-Baqir, who heard from Sajjad, who heard from Hussein, who heard from Ali, who heard from the Holy Prophet, who heard from Jibreel, who heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say what? And now he is about to mention this. Meaning, yahan par koi bhi aisi hasti nahi hai ke jo ghair masoom ho. Is hadith mein jitne bhi hain, sab ke sab masoom hain. Sab ke sab kya hain? Masoom hain. Samini girami. Alfaz kya hain? Kaha kalimatu la ilaha illallah. Ke yaad rakhna. La ilaha illallah, jise kalima ikhlas kehte hain ya kalima tayyiba kehte hain, durust hai? Ye kya hai? Hisni, faman dakhala hisni amina min adabi. Jibrail ne kaha ke Allah kehte hain. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ne kaha ke la ilaha illallah wo qala hai. Qala kise kehte hain? Yani castle, yani fortress, yani fort. Ye wo qala hai ke jisme jo bhi dakhil ho jayega to wo kya hai mere azab se aman pa jayega, meri punishment se azab jo hai wo nijat pa jayega, bach jayega. Itna kaha logon ne, ulama ne, raviyan ne, sab apne qalam rakh diye. Kaha theek hai, la ilaha illallah ke hum sab qail hain, khatam hogi baat, full stop. Us waqt full stop nahi hua karta tha, main abhi bayan kar raha hu, full stop. Theek hai, arbi zuban mein full stop nahi hai. Okay, jab full stop ho gaya, qalam rakh diya. اب جب قلم رکھا تو مولا رضا فرماتے ہیں اتنی جلدی مت کرو بشرتہا و شروطہا. مولا فرماتے ہیں نہیں, اس کی ایک شرط ہے, کچھ شرائط ہیں. سامعین گرامی, میں آپ سے ایک سوال پوچھتا ہوں. بشرتہا و شروطہا, اگر مولا فقط اتنا کہہ دیتے شروط, یعنی شرط و شروط, what's the difference? شرط is the singular word for condition, شروط is the plural word for condition. مثلا سیف and سیوف. One sword is called in Arabic, it's called saif. More than two swords are called suyuf. Likewise, shart is singular, shurut is plural. I ask Imam Ridha alayhi salam, in certain matns, you mentioned the word shart and shurut. Why? You could have just merely said that it has some conditions. Right? It should have been enough. No, Imam Ridha alayhi salam said, I am differentiating. Maybe the voice of Ridha alayhi salam will reach my ear where he is saying that, remember, I am telling the people the belief system of tashayyuh. I'm telling them la ilaha illallah comes first. And the shart that I'm speaking of is other than the shurut that I'm speaking of, because Muhammadur Rasulullah is right after Allah. And then the shurut is us Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. And that's why he is saying وَبِشَرْطِهَا وَشُرُوطِهَا, you won't get to the unity of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without Muhammad. Allah tak Muhammad ke baghair nahi pahunch paoge, lekin yaad rakhna, Ali ke baghair Muhammad tak na pahunch paoge. Yeah, sab milke. Yeah, mere 4 minute reh gaye, main mukhtasar karta hu. سامعین گرامی, کیا ہے کہ اللہ کے بغیر گزارا نہیں ہے. توحید ایک ایسی چیز ہے جس میں ہم کمپرومائز نہیں کرتے ہیں. نہ ہمارے ہاں شرک کا وجود ہے, نہ کفر کا وجود ہے. ہم وہ ہیں جنہوں نے توحید علی سے سیکھی ہے. ہم غالی نہیں ہیں, ہم مقصر بھی نہیں ہیں, ہم مشرک نہیں ہیں, ہم کافر نہیں ہیں. ہم نے علی سے توحید کو سیکھا ہے. سامعین گرامی, اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی منبع رحمت ہے, منبع نجات ہے, لیکن محمد کے ذریعے, علی کے ذریعے. لیکن رضا علیہ السلام فرماتے ہیں کافی نہیں ہے. وَبِشَرْتِهَا وَشُرُوتِهَا, ایک شرط ہے, کچھ شرائط ہیں. وَأَنَا مِن شُرُوتِهَا, مولا کیا وجہ اس کا, آپ کا کیا مطلب تھا کہنے کا؟ آپ اتنا کہہ دیتے کہ کچھ شرائط ہیں, وہ اہل بیت ہیں. آپ کو یہ کہنے کی کیا ضرورت پڑی کہ میں ان شرائط میں سے ہوں؟ تو شاید آواز آئے, تم سمجھے نہیں, کل کو زیدیہ بھی کہیں گے ہم شیعہ, اسماعیلی کہیں گے ہم شیعہ. اسی لیے روایت میں آیا ہے, جو بھی اقرار, من اقر بولایت الرضا فهو المؤمن, جو بھی ولایت رضا رکھے گا تو وہ مکمل ایمان پائے گا. کیوں؟ زیدیوں کے امام 4 امام تک, اسماعیلیوں کے امام 6 امام تک, سامعین گر واقفیوں کے امام 7 امام تک. لیکن جس نے رضا کو مان لیا, اسی نے محمد کو مانا, علی کو مانا, حسن کو مانا, حسین کو مانا, اور مہدی کو مانا. اسی نے سب کو مانا. jisne ye ajab riwayat hai jisne wilayat e riza ko qabool kiya usi ne sab ki wilayat ko qabool kiya jisne riza ki wilayat ko qabool kiya imamat ko qabool kiya usi ne allah ki tauheed ko mana nabuwat ko mana tamam imamon ko mana unse pehle bhi aur unke baad bhi isliye kaha ki ye riwayat aur kisi imam ke bare mein nahi hai yaqeen mane lekin kaha jo riza ko manega وہی کامل ایمان ہوگا آئیے اسی کے اختتام کے ساتھ میں ایک چھوٹی سی دعا مانگوں گا انشاءاللہ اور آپ سے التماس دعا کروں گا لیکن یہ یاد رکھیے گا انشاءاللہ آج خوشی کا دن ہے اختتامی طور پہ انشاءاللہ ایک ایسا نعرہ لگائیں گے جس کی روحانی آواز یہاں سے لے کر انشاءاللہ مشہد مقدس قبہ امام رضا علیہ السلام تک پہنچے گی جو اردو زبان سمجھتے ہیں ہاتھ بلند کر کے نعرہ حیدری اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد يا محمود بحق محمد يا أعلى بحق علي يا فاطر السماوات بحق فاطمة يا محسن بحق حسن يا قديم الإحسان بحق حسين عليه السلام بارِ الٰہ تجھے واسطہ ہے محمد و آل محمد کا اپنی عزت و عظمت کا تجھے واسطہ ہے امام رضا علیہ السلام کی شان و شوقت و مقام کا بارِ الٰہ ہم سب کے تمام مرحومین و مرحومات کی مغفرت فرما Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you to bless our mahafil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you, bihaqq Muhammad and Ali Muhammad, to descend your rahmat and barakat in our houses. Oh Allah, we ask you to give us the success and the tawfiq to do hajj, umrah, ziyarat, bil akhas, specifically the ziyarah of Imam Hussein Aba Abdullah. We ask you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to hasten in the reappearance of Yusuf Zahra alayhi salam. اللہ سبحانہ وتعالی ہم آپ سے دعا گو ہیں ہم سب کو مولا کے احوان و انصار میں سے قرار دے مولا سوائے ہمارے مولا کو اور جو ہے ہمیں کسی کی خوشی اور کسی کی رضا چاہیے نہیں ہے بارِ الٰہ ہمارے مولا کو ہم سے خوش و راضی فرما بارِ الٰہ تجھے واسطہ محمد و آل محمد کا ہمارے تقوی میں اضافہ فرما ہماری روحانیت میں اضافہ فرما ہمارے رزق حلال میں اضافہ فرما ہماری اولادوں کو اور ہمیں اس دنیا میں اور آخرت میں کامیاب و کامران فرما اس ادارے کو دن دگنی رات چگنی ترقی عنایت فرما سوائے اپنے اور کسی کا محتاج نہ بنا بارِ الٰہ دنیا بھر میں جہاں پر بھی مسلمانان بس رہے ہیں بارِ الٰہ بالخصوص شیعیان بس رہے ہیں بارِ الٰہ خصوصاً بالاخص آج کل فلسطین کے حالات بہت خراب ہیں یقین مانیے you know imagine the situation is such in Palestine right now that I'm sure all of you have seen that video where there are two girls lifting another girl from their hands and their feet. And when a person asked them, the videographer asked, what are you doing, children? Then the girl said, we are playing. And when they said, what are you playing? They said, we are playing the game of death. Yani for children, when even playing games have come to the point where they are playing death, then what must be the situation? Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask you to safeguard the Muslimin of Palestine. You know, I prayed not long ago, I prayed for the Palestinians and a mu'min stood up and said to me, how come you are praying? Some of them are nawasib, most of them are nawasib. I said, wallahi, I learned this from Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam, when he would go to Medina, he would go and he would distribute bread and salt. Bread and salt. Somebody asked, Mawla, you are giving bread to everyone, for those that believed in the wilayah of Amir al-Mu'mineen and for those that were opposing to the wilayah of Amir al-Mu'mineen. The Imam alayhi salam said, yes, because hunger does not see in what sect you are from. Hunger does not see it. The Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam has told us and they've taught us how to value in humanity. Insaniyat ki qadr hai. Lekin us waqt Mawla ne ek aur jumla kaha. اگر توجہات ہو مجھے پتا میں دعا مانگ چکا تھا لیکن میں نے دیکھا ابھی میرے دو منٹ ہیں وہ محبوب سے بھی جب وہاں کھڑے ہوئے اچھا اوکے وہ مولا نے کہا لیکن ایک فرق ہے تم نے دیکھا نہیں کہ میں بریڈ روٹی تو میں سب کے گھروں میں دے رہا تھا لیکن جس کے دل میں حب علی ہے اس کو میں نے نمک بھی دیا اسی لئے سمجھ لگی رسول خدا نے فرمایا تھا یا علی انت بمنزلتی ملح من الطعام یا علی آپ کی وہ منزلت ہے جو کہ کھانے میں نمک کی ہوتی ہے نمک میں کھانا نہ ہو تو بے مزہ رہتا ہے دل میں علی نہ ہو تو زندگی بے مزی رہتی ہے یا ربنا یا ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم بجاه محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات.